Yes, we are ready for live bullets, but we don't care. Bora see my head shot. Na watu wengi majenzi tuko na NHIF. Na wenye hatuna NHIF wako na linda mama
na kadi ya CBC.
Na wenye wana linda mama wako na kadi, tutatumia ile pesa ya boma yangu yenye tulikuwa tunalipa ya boma yangu na hatujairudishiwa. Ama ile pesa walikuwa watuambia hii tena tutatumia hiyo kutibu watu wetu.
Of course, to my amazing people, my name is Edgar and tuko hapa ndani ya Kibra, and that is we are having the Genzies all the way from Kibra ambao kwa kweli wangetaka kusema something. And with me, the different media houses, but we're here just to listen to them. So, nitakuwa na pia fursa, that is the Genzies from Kibra, tupate kusikia, because we know exactly coming tomorrow, that will be one of the awaited protests, that is Nane Nane. But meanwhile, pia tumetaka kusikiza kutoka kwao, hao binafsi, kama Genzies kutoka all the way from Kibra. I think I'll start with you. Utuambio kwa majina unaitwa nani, and so far, what are the plans so far?
So, kwa majina unaitwa Kelvin Owino Agure. Na kwa vile huwa tunajua itakuwa vibaya sana nikizungumza before chairman naongee. So nitamkaribisha chairman wetu anaitwa Dennis azungumze, alafu akimaliza nasi pia tutachangamka.
Na asanteni sana kwa kutualika hapa. Ni siku nzuri sana ya kuzungumzia yale ambayo yamekumba nchi yetu. Na sisi kama Gen Z kutoka Kibra hatufurahii mambo ambayo yanaendelea. Manake sasa tunaona kwamba the right course that we took as Gen Z from Kibra, which was to fight for our rights, fight for what belongs to us, has been overtaken by other people who are now coming with other ideas to be criminals among us and are being used as hooligans to come and counterattack the good cause that the GNZ from Kibra or worldwide started. And we are really condemning these acts, which is not good. It is not enshrined in our constitution, and we cannot at any given point allow any criminal acts to be seen as the face of GNZ. GNZ first is for peaceful demonstration, because that one has been enshrined in the constitution. And we want to tell those people that are being used by goons, or those people that are using goons to come and disturb the peace that GNZ are trying to portray outside here, that your days are numbered. And we are not at any given point going to allow you to destroy the good thing that people have started. This is a fight for democracy. This is a fight for equitable shares in this country. And we are saying that going forward, we won't allow any hooliganism among us. So if you are the financiers of these goons, we are telling you, be prepared, because we are not going to use the hooliganism on you, but we are going to use the right course, which is the Constitution of Kenya, and we are going to use the courts to bring you to book, because what you are doing is not good at all. We are not going to do this thing as usual. We are going to do it the right channel. Thank you.
My first question,
Yes.
You have been on this move, and so far we have seen exactly most of the people who have been on this move. Currently some of them are being attacked, and sometimes what do you think about this, and what are the measures you're keeping, you are taking to make sure that you are also you are safe, because most of the people who have been on the front line, most of them somehow they are being attacked by people. According to the reports, they are being said that they were hired to come and attack those who are on the front line.
What I can say that those people who are hired, or those people who are hiring these goons, we are saying these are cowards. These are cowards, because if you are doing the right thing that is within the constitution, then why should you send people to attack these kind of people? We've always preached a gospel of peaceful demonstrators. We are not there to destroy any property. We are not there to disturb any person's right, but we are doing something that it is stipulated in the constitution. So we are telling those people that are being sent, those people who are being used to come and attack people, that this is not the right thing. You know, from your own thought and mind, you know you are doing the wrong thing. But then you are being given little money,
you are going to attack someone, you are going to kill someone, you are going to destroy someone's business so that the image of GNZ can be destroyed or can be seen as a militia gang outside here. This is not what we are fighting for. This is not what we as GNZ are championing for. So we are telling those people this is not the right thing. I know even us who are on the live cameras, our lives are at risk. But then we are saying we are living for tomorrow. Because this thing that is happening now, it is not for today. It is for the coming generation. You remember the Mau Mau fought for us who are now fighting today. They fought for us to get that independence and we got it. Not that they are not enjoying it as at now, but those people whom they fought for, the generation who we are today, the millennial and Gen Z, are enjoying the rights. So we are also telling them, you will kill us, but you will not kill the vision. The vision will still proceed. And the generation that is coming will also fight the way we are fighting. Thank you.
The 20th years, sir, yes, currently been approved, and they're now kicking off their new duty. As per the cabinet they are holding, what is your intake on this? Are you satisfied with the 20 CS that were currently approved and are yet to start their normal duties?
Okay, about the vetting, I can say I might be okay with the cabinet. Okay, but then what I'm really against is about how the vetting took place. You know, because we are seeing a scenario whereby someone tells us his worth and the parliament does not question the source of this wealth. Because you cannot tell me someone started working in 1975, earning 2,800. And then till 2022, someone somehow has got 690, for example. Then come 2023 or 2024, within a span of 2 years, someone has accumulated 150 million. How comes that these, they always have an excuse of the appreciation of their assets? This does not make sense at all. They just have to tell us that they are using our money, they are stealing our money, and this is what we are calling for. We don't want such kind of activities in our Kenya. We know the salaries these people get. So when you are telling us that within a span of 2 years you've accumulated 150, you see, that is theft. It is theft, and everyone can tell, even the world can tell that is theft. So these people, the parliament that was responsible for vetting these ministers and cabinets, they would have questioned, how did you manage to get this 150 within this span of years, within this period of time? You see, because I think now people are taking advantage of these public offices. The only thing they are looking for is how to enrich themselves and to leave others poor. So people will always continue being poor, while those people who have money will always try as much as they can to steal more money and have more in their accounts. Yes.
Talking of vetting, during the vetting we saw that is Junet Mohammed trying to signal one of the cabinet was during a vetting, trying to communicate, you know, like telling the other person not to agree on a certain question that was being asked by Ichuga. Do you think there was a connection between the nominees who are being vetted the nominees that were being vetted during the parliament session, and the people who are vetting them? After the incident, do you think of such?
What I know and what I feel as a Kenyan is that there's no difference between those people who are vetting and those who are being vetted. These are the same kind of people. These people, they know their language, okay? So even this one was just for formalities. There's nothing so special about vetting. There's no such kind of a thing in Kenya. So we just see that this was just a way of showing Kenyans that yes, we followed due process by getting these people to power or to work for us. But in real sense, that was not vetting. It was just for formalities, for Kenyans to know, or even when someone challenges that to the court of laws, they will say, this is what the constitution requires the parliament to do, and this is what parliament did.
So there's nothing wrong. So this is just to wash, you know, to wash the dirty linen, because we know how it is. So these are the same people, same character, same everything. Yeah.
Mr. Chairman, but before we end, okay, tungle about Nane Nane. Siwa kesho kama kijana wa Kibra, Chairman Gen Z, umepanga vipi, mikakati vipi unaweza kuchukua kesho?
Siku ya kesho, vijana wamejipanga vilivyo, kutokea, kuchukua kile kitu ambacho wanaamini ni chao, na kwamba Gen Z hawatoki Nane Nane kwa vile serikali imefanya ama imetimiza matakwa yao. Wanatoka kwa ajili bado kuna upungufu ya mambo yale ambayo Gen Z walijaribu kueleza serikali, lakini tunaona kwamba vile vitu vyote ambavyo walizungumzia vyote vipo tu bado, unajua. So ni kana kwamba serikali inajaribu kuficha au inajaribu yani kucheza na akili ya wa Kenya kwa jumla. Manake kama tumesema kwamba wale viongozi ambao hatukuwataka rais akachukua jukumu na akawatoa akawatimua, tena na kuaje hao watu tena wanasafishwa kwa muda wa wiki mbili, wasafishwa na wanarudi tena kazi kufanya yale ambao alikuwa amefanya. Huyu ndio yule mtu ambaye bado aliingia kama ana shilingi, lakini alipotoka alipatikana ako na shilingi milioni 150. Hivyo sasa Gen Z wanasema hivyo ndio vitu ambavyo hatutaki kuona katika nchi yetu. Sisi tunataka kuona serikali ambayo inatimiza ahadi ambazo walipatia Wakenya. Na Wakenya watu wanajua ahadi ambazo walipewa. Unajua? Wanajua, si eti kwamba wajui. Na sisi tunataka kuona serikali inafanya vile vile ilivyoahidi Wakenya wakati wa kampeni zao.
Inasemekana kwamba Gen Z siku ya kwanza walijitokeza, siku ya pili wakajitokeza, ya tatu rais akashughulika about cabinets. But sasa hii people don't know what you guys want. Mnataka nini hasa? Imekuwa sana swali katika watu. Mnataka nini maandamano kila wakati? Je, imekuwa ni uharibifu wa mali? Je, imekuwa wengine wanachukua advantage of it? Nini shida iko wapi hasa?
Kitu cha kwanza ujue kwamba uharibifu wa mali si mambo ya Gen Z. Uharibifu wa mali inatokana na wale ambao wanaona kwamba wataadhirika. Manake unajua sasa ni ukweli unasemwa hapa. Na kuna yule mtu ambaye hapendi ukweli. So wakati ukweli unapojitokeza atajaribu juu chini afiche ukweli ambao upo. Unaona? So hivi vitu ambavyo unaona sijui kwamba yanaenea kule mitandaoni, sijui wapi, eti Gen Z ni watu ambao wanafanya uharibifu. Mambo yale ni uongo, na hatuwezi tukachukua kama ni kweli. Unajua? So hivi vitu vyote ni wale ambao wanaona kwamba wanakuwa na wanahisi kwamba hawako mahali pema, manake tutajua mali ambayo walituibia sisi kama Wakenya.
So lingine tena, kumekuwa na pale mshikaki pale hapa na pale kusana, mnatoka mnafuata the highest table, wakati macha pa nyumbani wa MP wenye wafanyi kazi, MMC wafanyi kazi, ila mnafuata kwanza huko juu. Vipi mmejipangaje kama Gen Z Kibra upande ya MC MP? Vipi mmeweza kuje kutokujitokeza mkaweza kugoma kusana na MP ama MC wafanyi kazi katika eneo lenu?
Unajua katika familia tuko na baba na tuko na mama, na mara nyingi huwezi kuadhibu mtoto kwa tabia mbaya. Mtu wa kwanza kwa kukashifiwa ni mzazi. Sasa tunahisi kwamba kuoza kwa serikali imeanza kule juu, na huko ndio tunataka mabadiliko. Manake yule ndiye ana nguvu zaidi ya kuambia hawa watu wa chini kwamba hatutaki corruption. Sisi agenda yetu kama watu wa UDA serikali, tulisema agenda yetu ni maendeleo ya wananchi wa Kenya, kutoka kwa mkulima mdogo kuenda juu. Lakini sasa tunaona kwamba shida ikiwa kule juu, hawa chini hawatajua ni kitu gani wanafaa kufuata. We have a leader, and a leader leads as others follow. So if you are not getting that leadership skill from above, then what do we need to do? We have to strike up as we come down. So when we do that, then these people who are ambao wako chini watahisi kwamba there is some effect that are being felt within the country. Yes.
Inasemekana kwamba ni serikali ya nitafanya, nitatenda, si namna hiyo. Huo unaichukulia vipi?
Hicho au mambo yale ndio mambo ambayo yanatukera sisi kama vijana. Manake kutenda. Sasa hivi ni miaka mbili jamani tumekuwa katika serikali. Tulikuwa na matumaini makubwa sana kwa hii serikali. Unajua, tulikuwa na matumaini. Lakini sasa matumaini yetu yameambulia patuku. Manake vile vitu ambavyo walisema wametenga na watatenda hatuoni yakitendwa. Tukisema kwamba kama ni barabara, tunajua yule aliyekuweko mwanzo Mheshimiwa Uhuru Kenyatta ndiye alifanya hivi barabara. Lakini kwa sasa hatuna maendeleo yote ambayo tunaona kwamba inaendelea. Unajua hata kama tunasema ni China inatengeneza barabara, hatujaona mega projects in roads. The infrastructures are not there. Tukisema mambo na Linda Mama, hakuna kitu ambacho kinaendelea pale. Wamama bado wanasumbuka kwenda hospitalini. Na hawa ndio wale ambao walituahidi, wakaahidi wamama wetu, hamtapitia mambo magumu katika inchi hata kama umepata ujauzito. Tutaishughulikia. Lakini wapi jamani? Miaka miwili iweze kuwa kwamba unapanga serikali kwa miaka miwili. Tumebaki na miaka mitatu. Ambapo kwa miaka mitatu tukiangalia kweli tuna miaka miwili tu ya kufanya kazi. Manake mwaka wa mwisho ni ule mwaka wa kampeni. Na huo hatuwezi sema kwamba tunatarajia maendeleo yote. Sasa kama miaka miwili tayari ishapita, miaka miwili ijayo nini atakayofanyika ambaye hajafanyika miaka miwili iliyopita? Naam.
Ah, kumekuwa pale na president alisema kwamba anaruhusu kazi mtaani. Je, mmeweza kupokea habari kuhusiana kazi mtaani ama vipi?
Kazi mtaani hata hivyo ni maneno tu yalizungumziwa, yalinenwa, na hatujapata ripoti yoyote kuhusu kazi mtaani, hatujaelekezwa. Unajua tatizo la serikali yetu ni kwamba communication ni shida. Unajua ukisema kule State House kwamba unarejesha kazi mtaani, vijana ndio hawana kazi, lakini unaelekeza wapate vipi hivi kazi? Kama ni chifu wa eneo, sema tafadhali vijana kutoka eneo fulani nendeni kwa chifu mjiandikishe. Tangu waseme mambo ya vijana mtani, hatujapata ripoti yote kwamba tunaweza tukaenda kwa nani tukapata habari zaidi kuhusu kazi mtani.
Sawa. Mimi ni kutoka Spice TV. Spice TV Kenya, na ningependa kuuliza kitu moja. What are you expecting tomorrow, because the number was to eat 3 million strong. Then kuja pamoja to Nairobi, yeah, for the protest. So naona kama hiyo number inaweza fika ama watu wameogopa.
Okay, we are anticipating that that number might be hit. And again, another thing is that everyone fears for his life. Okay, everyone fears for his life. You remember the final, or let me say the one that captured the world was June 25th. But then the rest, you know, they kind of brought some fears to this generation. These are young people who have got no weapons. They are not even planning to even bring any harm to the country. What they are just trying to ask is for them to be heard, and for what they are asking is to be brought to existence. You know, if it's about accountability, if it's about corruption, these are things that we can see. But then when now it comes that now we are being targeted, we are being harassed, we are being abducted, you know, some are being killed, it is something that can instill fears in many youths. So we are saying yes, people are fearing for their lives, but the cause has to be undertaken. We have to do this so that the government can feel the presence of youths in this country. We wanted a listening government. That is all what we are asking for. That's all we are asking for.
So the other the previous protest where the government changed the way of tackling the protesters, so we saw the policemen came in plain clothes and then number plateless cars, you see? I think you saw. Most people saw that.
Yes.
So how are you going to handle this? Because that is a big risk to the youth.
I believe that those people, let me say police that are being used, because these are not policemen. They are people being used. And I think there are people who took an oath that all what they can do is to kill. Okay? So we are telling these people, they also have children, they also have families,
And we have no power or we have no weapons to counter attack what they are doing to us. All what we are telling them that one day it will be paid. Okay? We have no machinery to counterattack them. So for them, they are using the weapons. We are using the word and we are using the wisdom and knowledge that we have. You see? So I know they are working around that area, and I know most of them, many of them, they are everywhere. Okay? They are everywhere. So we are very keen. We've mastered their moves. Okay? And we are prepared for that. Okay? Because all what we know, we are doing the right thing. We are not doing the wrong thing in this country. The only thing we are doing is to protest, to air our views, to air our opinions. Okay? So if someone wants to silence us by using the plainclothes goons, let me say that, because police officers are people who took oath of office to protect our lives. These people are not protecting our lives. They are killing us, which is not even in the Constitution. In fact, the Constitution even took away that power of even court to rule that someone can go under hanging as a death sentence, you know. So for them, now they are using that, which is not even in our Constitution. So we are telling them, we are there, we are going to do the right thing, we are not going to go against the law. The law is what.
So you believe that the youth are really prepared for the plainclothes policemen? Or can we call them policemen, or we call them goons? I don't know. Because that's the word.
You know, yes, for me, I will call them goons, because police are well known. These are people who've gone under training. They've gone under training on how to tackle protesters and demonstrators. But these people who are coming on number plate vehicles, their eyes are masked, you know. These are not people. They don't want to be seen. Why? Why are they hiding? Why do you kill someone and then you hide? It's like beating me at night, you know. Why don't you come during the day? Let us face each other. Let us talk. If you want us to talk, if you want to kill me, let me know so-and-so is killing me. Okay? But then you can't kill me, then I don't know. My family doesn't know that you are killing me. Okay? So these are not real people. If they are real men and they are servants of this country, they shouldn't do that. They shouldn't be used. Let them come with their face well visible, that we can tell this is so and so, this is so and so. Yes.
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Chairman, as you know that we have those who propose and oppose the motion, right? So tomorrow, as you guys are going to demonstrate, those who have been paid, or maybe they haven't been paid, they want to be strapped in your demonstration, what kind of message will you send them?
People who have been paid?
To the people who might lie to distract. That is the peaceful demonstration that you guys are having tomorrow, the Gen Z's are having tomorrow, or the goons who sometimes have been paid. I'm not confirming this, but I'm saying in quotes, sometimes they have been paid to come and distract the peaceful protest tomorrow. What message do you have for them?
I will tell them money loses value. Money loses value. And when we stand for the truth shall stand. Okay? It will stand. So money loses value. You will take it today. Tomorrow,
watu wasijaribu kuharibu biashara ya watu na watu tunaenda hadi patrol. Even this is the evidence here, we have evidence here, we are going patrol even to Mombasa. These are direct live tickets for our Gen Z patrol guys. You can read Nairobi Mombasa tomorrow, August 8th. Mash power. Gen Z tulisema tuna sponsor, si ndo tuna sponsor. We're going to patrol there. We see Mombasa pia kunaendaje, Nairobi kunaendaje. Na unajua hizo mabasi zina kimbia kama ndege. Hivyo kumaanisha majenzi, ma head boys kama sisi na gure, we are use helicopter ama
we fly high.
Yeah. So anything else from that itakuwa ni stories za jaba. And tukumbuke tuko August holiday, watoto wanatuwatch live. People are watching us live. So we must compose ourselves. Yes, we are ready for live bullets, but we don't care. Bora si my head shot. Na watu wengi majenzi tuko na NHIF. Na wenye hatuna NHIF, wako na linda mama.
Na kadi ya CBC.
Na wenye wana linda mama, wako na kadi. Tutatumia ile pesa ya boma yangu, yenye tulikuwa tunalipa. Ya boma yangu na tujairudishiwa. ama ile pesa walikuwa watuambia hii sitini tutatumia hiyo kutibu watu wetu. So watu pia wasijai gas sana, lakini watu wajai gas, lakini wasijai gas sana, pia pia watu wasitulie sana. But lakini don't hurt your neighbor, don't use this Nane Nane thing to like raid on your neighbor's businesses or steal or hurt someone. That will be nonsense. We will deal with you perpendicularly, diagonally, horizontally. Tuko na watu on the ground, na tunatafuta wenye wanalipa magoons chini ya maji. Pia we shall put them to test. And everybody will be arrested according to section 9, cap 4 of the kitu inaitwa citizen arrest. Na wapeleko machief viboko, alafu turudi tuendelee na tear gas. Asanteni.